Officials from the Ministry of Works have decried the worrying trend of vandalism on the Entebbe Express Highway. This was during their interface with the Committee of Fiscal Infrastructure over vandalism of road infrastructure on Kampala Entebbe Express Highway.
A total of about 44,000 kilometers of fencing. I would like to concentrate on meters of fencing, of which a total of about 30,000 have been vandalized.
In a space of 1 year, a total of 30,588.68 meters of chain link have been vandalized out of 44,386 meters of the fence.
Most of the fencing has been was vandalized earlier before the tendering process of this O&M contract. So what we did at that time when we were doing the tendering, we evaluated and saw that about 6-7 kilometers of the fencing was stolen already.
Increased vandalism is attributed to rampant market of metal scrap, which is being used as raw materials for steel products. According to UNRWA, the cost to repair the vandalized road infrastructure amounts to 58.85 billion shillings. UNRWA unveiled plans to replace 7.5 kilometers of the chain link, which was vandalized before Aegis Road Operation took charge of the Kampala Entebbe Express Highway.
We agreed with the contractor that the 7.5 kilometers of the fencing that was stolen prior to their commencement of activity will be met by UNRWA. So we are going to replace that fence, and the cost will be borne by government, and that's UNRWA will pay.
However, members of the Committee on Fiscal Infrastructure are not convinced with action taken against vandals. Some cited gaps in security presence on the road and absence of a lighting system.
I don't know why they delay to prosecute the criminals instead of expediting them. What are they waiting? What's the challenge that they have such that they don't prosecute these people? Because there are evidences with these materials that they were caught with.
On that expressway, there are some cameras. And so it would be prudent to understand from the team of UNRWA whether those cameras that are on that road cannot be used to catch some of these people who are vandalizing this road furniture.
Legislators also tasked UNRWA to carry out corporate social responsibility programs for communities around Entebbe Express Highway in order to bond the community with the road.
A medical facility, and the committee knows that this money is coming from the collection. So they will now protect this road because they are getting a free or access something out of this road.
Can't we think of concrete like we used to do a long time ago? You remember those roads, the colonial roads? They had concrete, good concrete, quality concrete. Can't we rethink about using concrete?
The Uganda National Roads Authority is now planning to use materials that are not attractive to vandals, including concrete, to fence the express highway.
We are now investigating what material are we going to use which may not be attractive to these vandals. Maybe if we do that, it may be more expensive, but we have to do that because the road must be protected.
UNRWA has also committed to install lighting systems on Entebbe Express Highway before the end of March 2023, plus cameras as a measure to curb vandalism of road infrastructure.
There is a provision of lighting the entire expressway in the contract.
Report compiled by Fred Kajibi for the news at Parliament.